What's up? Welcome back to my channel. My name is JC. I am Ron Strong. Today we're talking about Edgar Valdez, aka La Barbie. Mexican-American drug lord and lieutenant for the Beltran Leyva cartel based out of Sinaloa. La Barbie worked his ass off to rise to the top. He was an enforcer for a squad called Los Negros, and I'll tell you a little bit more about them at the end. He is doing time now at a very high federal security prison, and guess who he's doing time with?
Cartel got me working for the big faces. Federale got my car full of brick cases. Hit the pen with a grin, there ain't no faking. Eyes picked to my back for my shoelaces. Got out, should've seen the look on they faces. All jealous cause your boy stacking hella paper. Set up by the crew, they done put a banger in the trunk of my car and left me to hang there. No thing, then attorney went and beat the case. Got a job digging holes for minimum wage. Had a dream that Cato said he proud of me. Stay here, don't leave, keep doing your thing. Quit the drugs, but you know I went back to selling. Six time failing, I went back to prison. Got my head right, got my bread right. Push these weights like a kilo in a tailpipe. Trying to do right, I got a mission. Trying to give back to my boys in the prison. The old me's gone, I ain't never gonna miss them. From wrong to strong, stay true to the vision.
From wrong to strong. From wrong to strong. From wrong to strong. From wrong to strong.
What's up, Raza? Welcome back. This is my channel. If you're new to my channel, make sure you subscribe. Hit the bell so you don't miss nothing. This is not a cooking channel unless we're doing prison recipes. Other than that, what's up, Raza? Get into the Suburban. We're about to go on a ride. Yeah, La Barbie is serving 49 years right now at the USP Coleman 2. Tell you a little bit more about that prison. It's a very high security federal prison in Florida. He was born in Laredo, Texas, and I mean, he was an American kid, man. He played football, he played track, he did track, was popular in school. He got his nickname actually from his high school coach because, you know, he was light-complected with the blue eyes and, you know, that Ken doll look. But, you know, it's funny because they think that all Mexicans are like short and dark. I mean, I am short, but I mean, at least I got green eyes, but you know, we're not all short and dark. If you go to Mexico, you'll see a lot of blonde people over there. He was arrested at 19 in Texas for a negligent homicide. He ran over a school teacher. He was already selling weed in Laredo. He was known, you know what I mean, in high school. And the thing is that he was already getting into trouble. He got caught up on a case about the shooting marijuana. So in order for him to avoid, you know, getting charged with that, he fled to Mexico where he met the Beltran Leyva cartel. I mean, like most Americans that run from the U.S., we do what we need to do to eat. You know, I met a lot of brothers that have ran to Mexico. It's not the same place as America, especially if you're used to being here already. You kind of do what you have to do. So, you know, he moved up quickly in the ranks due to his connections in the U.S. He pleaded guilty in January of 2016 to conspiracy to import cocaine and money laundering and got 49 years. But, I mean, he was 49 years old. That means that he'll spend the rest of his life in prison, but if he is still alive, he will be doing 10 years of probation when he gets out. I think he'll be like 90 something, I'm not sure, but be an old guy, but you know, who knows? Maybe if he stays healthy enough, he could get out. At one time, La Barbie was El Chapo's top lieutenant. The war against his rivals, the Gulf cartel and the Zetas, in the mid-2000s, the Zetas and the Sinaloa fought a long, bloody turf war that you guys know about for Nuevo Laredo. There was a lot of bodies, a lot of blood, a lot of stuff going on. Smuggling routes are what makes the money, and we're not talking small money, we're talking really big amounts of money. So it's very, very important to control those borders and those smuggling routes. So that's why it caused an all-out war, you know. But he was a key soldier in all those battles, so you know, he earned his respect. Finally, the DEA built a case on him and seized 100 kilos, $4 million, and a bunch of firearms. Remember, in this lifestyle, everything comes to an end sooner or later. I mean, at least he didn't get charged with a lot of things, but the thing is that you either end up in prison or you end up dead. You know, this dude was no joke. So I think he's kind of lucky. Especially that he's in a prison in the U.S. Los Negros was an armed wing of the Sinaloa cartel. They originally were formed to fight with the Zetas and worked for Beltran Leyva cartel. But after the death of Arturo, they split up in half and they went through what we call a power struggle. Fighting, you know, broke out of control, and the Beltran Leyva took one half of them, and then Barbie took the other half, and they were, you know, fighting for control. After Barbie got arrested, the Negros pretty much collapsed and fell apart. They were done. USP Coleman 2 is a special yard. It is so-called a safe zone. And for those that haven't been to prison or anything, it is a safe zone because it's for informants, cops, ex-gang members, check-ins. Check-ins means that guys going to prison, they're afraid to walk a normal yard. So they tell the guard, hey, I'm in fear for my life. And they send them to a special yard. Of course, they run a whole background check on him first to see if he's like trying to go there to go hit anybody. And by that I mean take somebody out. But yeah, they have these special yards in the federal prison that they send special people to. You know, if they go to regular yards, these are yards where they'll be probably stabbed, or you know, they'll be doing really hard time. And guess who he's doing time with there? He's doing time there with Benjamin Arellano Felix, the Tijuana cartel leader. Yeah, he's there also. I think he's got 63 years, I'm not sure. You know, I always tell people, it's all fine and dandy until they catch you. I remember plenty of times where I was making, you know, 30, 40 grand and going to the mall and everything, and you know, popping bottles, doing all that stupid stuff. And then when they would handcuff me, yeah, it wasn't fun no more. You do not want to spend the rest of your life in prison. I forgot what they did. When I did the RDAP program in the federal prison, they told us to do the math on how much money we had made and then divide that by the years that we had been in prison and the hours and everything. I forgot how we did the math, but it ended up to being like, I would have made more money staying out working at McDonald's than working and getting caught and all that stuff. So this is why I share these stories. Yes, it is narco culture. Yes, it is gangs. Yes, it is part of all my life that I grew up with. But I do not glamorize it. I do not wish it on anybody. I share information so you could learn from all this. Well, Wrong Strong family, my name's JC. I am Wrong Strong. Don't judge nobody. Give somebody a hug. Stay in your lane. Be savage. And remember, you only have one life to live. But if you live it right, one life is all you need. I'll check you guys out later.